Sometimes you come across human-induced climate change deniers and skeptics on social media, who are often professional disinformers and conspiracy theorists. They often monetize their disinformation via their websites and through advertising revenue, or via fossil fuel lobby group funding. Here's an example, Tony Heller, also known as Stephen Goddard. Heller is a member of the fossil fuel lobby group funded CO2 Coalition, and Heller is also a Sandy Hook conspiracy theorist. Some time ago, Heller blocked me from commenting on his social media commentary after I discovered an elaborate trick he was using to confuse his followers. Tony used this image, claiming it showed that Arctic sea ice was lower in the last century than this century. Here's how he tricked his audience by using a mislabeled graph. The graph he shows is not, in fact, the annual mean Arctic ice cover. How do we know? Because we can find the original text translation of the paper he cited, which is Vinnikoff et al. From 1980. Now, two things to point out before we take a look at that translation. Heller often mistakes sea ice extent and sea ice area. Sea ice area is the total region actually covered by ice. Extent is the total region with at least 15% sea ice cover. And as a result, extent gives a higher value than area. Okay, let's dive in. The original translation is available online, and Vinnikoff produced an annual sea ice cover graph, but he also showed cover for each month. But Heller used only the late August ice cover graph, when sea ice is very low, but suggested it was annual sea ice by using a mistranslated version of Vinnikoff found in later documents. This is why it's key to go back to the original sources. Of course, even if we look at the observational sea ice records, back to 1850 for shipping surveys, we still see a clear decline after the 1970s. If we look at this century, we still see Arctic sea ice decline, and it is lower now than in the 20th century. Oh, and by the way, don't be fooled by short-term variations and Heller's cherry picks. It is best to look at global sea ice, or even better, global ice on land and sea, which continues to decline each decade at an accelerating rate. And as the land ice goes into the sea, it contributes to sea level rise,